Hey folks, it's Antar, and I'm just here to wish you all a happy Valentine's Day. And if it's not such a happy Valentine's Day for you because you are without a significant other, take some consolation in this bit of knowledge. I found a spouse. Odds are, you can too. But anyway, on to more serious matters. I have a brand new team, fresh off the breeding mat, I don't know, the daycare center. Yeah, anyway, 6 new breeds, and I'm hoping that this team will be a little bit more competitive than my last singles team. My opponent today is Bruticus Force of YouTube. There should be a link to his channel in the annotations and in the description. But yeah, so I go ahead and lead off with my peanut. My pink elephant. It's not quite pink enough, but it's a little pink, I guess. I guess that's more orange. I don't know. Maybe I can screw around with the color settings. And he leads off with his Tyranitar. We both set up our stealth rocks, and yeah. So anyway, his Tyranitar is faster, naturally, because I'm not going to invest anything in the speed of a freaking Donphan. But he goes ahead and attacks me with Crunch. But the thing about Donphan is it's more physically defensive than specially defensive, so I'm not going to mind that crunch, and I'm going to hit back with a super effective Earthquake, which isn't going to be helped at all by the fact that there's a sand, or which isn't going to be hurt at all by the fact that there's a sandstream, a sandstorm going, which boosts T-Tar's special defense. But so anyway, I've gotten him down to low enough HP that I can KO him with an Ice Shard, but unfortunately he switches out before I can do so. So out comes a Doryuzu, I don't remember that thing's name, Excadrill, I think, but it's not all bad news, because that Ice Shard does a significant amount of damage, and it pops his balloon, so that now I can hit him with a super effective Earthquake, but not before he hits me, because, you know, not that he would outspeed me anyway, but thanks to the fact that there's a sandstorm going, that thing is fast as anything, and when I was looking at his team, I saw that thing and I was like, oh man, that's going to be the biggest threat to me in this game. But thankfully, Peanut is freaking awesome. You know, it's running max HP, so it's really awesome that it was able to survive that attack and KO with a super effective Earthquake. Not sure why my opponent sent T-Tar back out, because I have shown that I have Ice Shard. But yeah, I go ahead and take him out. Him out? Her out? That's a him. But anyway, I take him out on the next turn with an Ice Shard, so that's awesome. I've taken out two of his guys with a Pokemon that's really just supposed to be there to set up Stealth Rocks and not die. Before that happens. Anyway, I get hit by a Mach Punch. I wasn't actually figuring that Conkeldurr would be running Mach Punch, which is stupid because every Conkeldurr runs Mach Punch. So that was a poor move on my part, and yeah, I needlessly sacrificed my Donphan. Not that it really would have been able to do much anyway. I mean, I think it could have survived the Stealth Rocks one more time if I'd switched him back in, but not positive. Anyway, he's got a Burungeru, Jellicent on his team, so I wasn't going to go for the Hydro Pump, even though it would have been the thing that did the most damage. I was going to go for a Volt Change, predicting the switch into Jellicent. Instead, it was a switch into Notori, also known as Ferrothorn, I think. Anyway, I go ahead and switch in my Roomba, my Magnezone, who you might remember from my Harper team, also my Gore team back in the PBR days. It's actually a new breed because Explosion isn't really useful anymore. But yeah, so it's still a Steel Trapper. It still does the same thing. And so I get on off my sub thinking that he was going to go for a Leech Seed. Unfortunately for me, he doesn't. He went for the Spikes. And that's gonna not be good for my team because Donphan was my spinner, and yeah, and I'm pretty sure besides my balloon floating Roomba, I think everyone else is going to be on the ground and is going to feel those spikes. But anyway, I figure I'm gonna want to KO him with a hidden power fire, but alas, it does not. He hangs on with like 1 HP, but I'm really lucky that his power whip did not break my sub. That was maybe a bit of hacks, you know, maybe it was min damage, but I am super lucky there, and I do go for the hidden power to knock him out the rest of the way. So that's awesome. I have KO'd his Notori, Ferrothorn, and there's only been one layer of spikes. So yeah, so next up for him is his Landalos. which I'm like, oh, shoot, this is not going to be good. But luckily, he decides to be greedy and set up with a swords dance, and I'm going to go ahead and use Flash Cannon, which is not going to be super effective or anything, but surprisingly, it does a whole hell of a lot of damage. I mean, look at that. That's an easy two-hit KO. So it was a mistake on his part that he remitted after the battle, that he did not just go and break my sub on the first turn, but now he breaks my sub. But I'm going to be able to KO him with Flash Cannon. Flash Cannon's a really awesome move to have on this guy because it's got pretty good neutral coverage, gotta say. I mean, I know that steel is resisted by a lot of guys, but it's not resisted by a lot of guys who also resist electric-type moves. Anyway, Conkeldurr is back out, and I'm fearing the Mach Punch, so Roomba's going to be called back. And I'm going to go ahead and send in Dave, my star child, my Ranunculus. I don't know how to pronounce it. Dave is a reference to 2001 A Space Odyssey, which if you don't have ADD, it's a very worthwhile movie to watch. But I figure that he'll resist anything that Conkeldurr can do. And yes, some leftovers recovery, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, Conkeldurr goes ahead and uses Payback, which is going to hit me really hard, even though he went first. That's an easy two-hit KO on his part, and that is not good. I go ahead and use Psycho Shock. I know he's gotten a bulk up off, but I just don't want Focus Blast to miss. A battle that I'll be uploading later, basically, it was determined by the fact that Focus Blast missed, so I just didn't want that happening again. I'm figuring that, you know, granted Leftovers is canceling out the Sandstorm for him, but I still figure that, you know, he's down to on his last leg, and I'm pretty sure I can take him out pretty soon. I go ahead and send out my Tachikoma, my Rotom Wash form. Yeah, this is a different breed than the Rotom that is on my doubles team, which is a different breed than the Rotom that was on my UU singles team and my UU doubles team back in Gen 4, but they're all named Tachikoma. There's lots of Tachikomas if you watch Ghost in the Shell, and that's okay. But anyway, Tachikoma doesn't really get to do much in this match. It gets KO'd by Conkeldurr's Payback and then Mach Punch. So yeah, kind of wasted, kind of sucks. But, you know, it's a good Pokemon. I like it a lot. And it usually does better than that. So anyway, I go ahead and send out my Human, which is my Emboar. If you're curious why it's named Human, I can, you know, tell you. I'll put it in the comments. But yeah, so anyway, I figure that Human has is really, really bulky. Not that it has a lot of defenses, it actually just has a lot of HP. And it's actually invested in HP because it runs moves that deal recoil damage. I figured that I could take whatever he was going to dish out and hit him back with Nitro Charge, and that would be enough to kill him. But unfortunately, he switches out. Luckily, I did not go for a superpower, because that wouldn't have hit his Berengar, also known as Jellicent. Anyway, there's the Jellicent that we haven't seen before. I'm gonna go ahead and Grass Knot this guy, because this is a mixed set. It runs positive speed nature. It's designed to, counter a lot of, you know, Scissor and, Tyranitar. So it's fairly fast. But unfortunately Grass Knot doesn't do anything. I'm hit by a Boiling Water, and I'm fully expecting to survive this, and I do, but unfortunately I don't survive with enough HP to survive the additional Sandstorm damage. But yeah, Human is kind of awesome. Hit by a super effective Boiling Water and does not die. Yeah, well, I mean, it does die, but not due to the attack, due to the Sandstorm. Anyway, proceeding on, I go ahead and send out my Roomba now to kill this guy with a Thunderbolt, and if he switches into Conkeldurr, he's down to his last two Pokemon, so either way I get a KO, and it's all good. So Roomba goes ahead and uses Thunderbolt. That's gonna go ahead and kill his Jellicent, and now my opponent is down to his last Pokemon, and I've got three left. So I'm hoping I can pull this off. Even though the Conkeldurr is kind of amazing. I was hoping that the Stealth Rocks would do more damage than that, but they don't. And so here comes the Mach Punch, and I'm hoping to survive, and I do with 8 HP, like a champ. That's totally awesome. I don't know whether that was min damage, but that was totally awesome. And I do win the match, and there we go. Anyway, Bruticus Force, great battle. I want to battle you again someday. Everyone else, comment, rate, subscribe, challenge, and enjoy your V-Day. So long.